Welcome to the Huddle. I'm Britt Johnson. I'm here with Matt Demecki.
What's happening?
And it's Friday.
It's Friday. It's Friday. Oh my gosh. It's Friday.
It's Friday. We still have jobs.
Yep.
We still don't have nothing to do, but we have jobs. That was kind of like a Friday.
Who won yesterday?
I don't know. Who did win yesterday?
You know
Why
what?
Don't you guys let us know in the comments below?
No, you know what? Dave, let me see something real quick. I just gotta rep this real quick.
Get this out of here.
Fly, Eagles, fly, baby. Let's go. Let's go. 5-1, Britt.
Yeah, let's throw that on the ground where it belongs. He threw it on the ground where it belongs.
We're going to the Super Bowl, Britt. Let's go.
I just want to say that. Okay, well, let's talk about yesterday's game. So, Tony Romo was commentating, as he does on Thursday Night Football, and take a look at this.
It was a touchdown against the Eagles. Terrence Williams. Was it the last pass?
Don't you dare start that.
Okay, Matt Demecki, what do you think about this? Should Tony Romo come out of retirement?
It's crazy watching him during these broadcasts. I think, first of all, I want to say Tony Romo is a fantastic broadcaster. I mean, the ratings on CBS have gone through the roof since Tony Romo's taken over. I think he is itching to play, and I think he could still play. The only concern with me with Tony Romo is the injuries. I mean, the dude's back is fragile. He's fragile as a whole. I mean, but he can still play.
Fragile with care.
Right, if he gets back into the NFL right now, he's better than already half the quarterbacks in the league.
Well, I mean, that's not saying much right now.
There's lousy quarterback. That's what I'm saying. Like, he can still return.
Well, I absolutely disagree with you.
Why?
What are you thinking?
Why?
Because, like, why would Tony Romo come back and say, first off, he found something he's amazing at. He tells dad jokes. He's witty. He's, like, he's sharp. He's, like, his analysis is amazing. Like, why would he let go of all of that? Mind you, CBS would still hold his job for him
because
he is that amazing. But why would he do that to go back to a job that nobody likes him at? Like, I was maybe one of the 8% that actually liked Tony Romo. Everyone talked crap about him all day. I think that's the only reason, honestly, you want him back is so you can talk more crap.
It's entertaining when Tony Romo's in the league. Like, there's
some
players.
It's entertaining with him, but he's still in the league, technically. He's commentating. Stay where you are, Tony, because the people that say you should come out of retirement are only saying that because they want something to laugh at.
Look.
They want you to get hurt again. They want you to get, like, barely sacked, and then you're out for the next 3 years. Like, don't do it. Don't do it.
Look, Tony Romo's on the wrong side of 30. But we could all agree he could still play. I'm telling you, he's better than so many. He's better than Brian Hoyer. You got other trash quarterbacks out there in the league. If he comes back maybe 1-2 years to a playoff contending team, and then he goes back to the booth, what's wrong with that?
So wait,
he's gonna have a job.
Where do you suggest Tony Romo go back to?
A team, a specific team?
Yes.
All right, I'm just gonna throw one out there. I say the Jacksonville Jaguars because they have an outstanding defense. They have a great running game. They have decent receivers. And if you put Tony Romo back there, they'll probably be the number 2-3 seed in the AFC. They really will.
And like the whole AFC?
And the whole AFC.
Oh, that's interesting.
And I would only put Kansas City and New England above them, and that's it. If Tony Romo were to go back.
Dave, is Matt smoking today? Did he take something before I came
in? I didn't take anything. I'm being for real.
Do you have a fever? You're a little warm.
Because I'm hot about this topic. Tony Romo should come back play for a couple years.
You know what?
He's itching to play.
I think this is the perfect time to move to the second portion of Friday Huddle Session, and that is our week's L's. Matt Demecki, what is your L? Who is your L this week?
It's not who, it's a team, a collective team. I think it's the New York Giants who take the L. Just because Brandon Marshall's out for the year now, Odell's gone, Janoris Jenkins is frustrated with his role, Dominique Rogers-Cromartie left the team during the week. So Giants are such a mess right now. I think the coach is going to get fired probably next week.
Yeah.
Got to take that L, Giants.
That's a good L. Well, I know I said I wasn't going to do it, but my L this week is Matt Demecki. And just for
this is like the third time, by the way.
Well, stop losing. Stop being a sucky person. No, this week your L is very well confirmed because earlier this week you told me in confidence that you thought the Panthers were going to win Thursday Night Football as an Eagles fan.
I did. You know why? Because I'm actually a reasonable fan. I'm not a fan that goes insane. But
well,
I'm actually reasonable.
Okay, well, why be a sports fan then? That's not a real sports fan.
Just because they were playing
Thursday
night on
the road.
We all
know sports fans are all insane.
I'm just a reasonable.
Stay insane. Don't be like Matt Demecki and go against your team. And then when your team wins, try to throw jerseys up like you had their back the whole time.
I'm just a reasonable fan.
No.
I'm just going to say
that. There's no such thing. That's like an oxymoron, okay? You can't be a reasonable fan. We know you guys are slightly reasonable or not, but let us know what you guys think about what we talked about today in the comments below. Like, subscribe, and finally this time, I know I've been saying we'll see you next week every day this week, but really, we'll see you next week.
We'll see you next week.